So good morning everyone. So in this video we are going to discuss about some other types of translational problem. Okay, so here the question they are given is obtain the transfer function of the mechanical system as shown in figure, writing the physical system equations. Okay, so in this equation, so in this question they are given as a spring constant K1 is here and mass M1 and M2. So the K will be acting in between M1 and M2, F dash part is acting between M1 and M2, and the displacement caused over in this M1 is X1, okay, and displacement caused in the M2 is X, okay. If you see, if a force will be acting, which is the maximum moment that will be takes place in the mass M2, so that is X, so that this is we are going to take in terms of output, okay. So which is the input? F of t is the input, and also other two damping forces it will be acting over here, that is a F1 over in the M1 and F2 over in the M2, okay. So these are all the forces that will be acting on this particular problem. So first, initially what we are going to do in the all the problems, first initial step we are going to draw the free body diagram. So I'll draw in the free body diagram, mainly it is going to mention the some of the resisting forces as well as the external forces. Okay, first we are going to take the M2. So in the M2, which are all the forces it will be acting? The external force it will be acting on here M2 is the F of t, and due to that, what is the displacement it causes? X it will be causes. What are all the other resisting forces? Due to the own self force, that is Fm2, and this is the F2 as well as K and gap. Okay, so these are all the forces that will be acting over here. So here we are taking as a Fs a force, so that dash part in terms of F we are going to consider as a B. Okay, otherwise it will be going to confuse, so that F we are going to take in terms of B, so that M finally, after finding the transfer function, you can convert it, it's not issue. So that FB2, FM2, FK and FB2. So these are all the resisting forces it will be acting over here, that is they are mentioned over here. So F of T and RB2, so that is the reaction forces, RB2, RK, RB, RM2, okay. If you check RB2 only, it will be acting over here, so that we are going to take X. So RK we are taking M2 mass, so that RK into X minus X1, okay. So if RB also we are taking mass M2, so that here displacement is X, and here it will be connected to the M1 mass, so that it will be X1 also get taken over here, X minus X1. Okay, like this way we are going to take it, and RM2, own self mass. Okay, so this is the free body diagram of this. So in this one we are going to substitute into the D'Alembert's principle. Okay, so if what is the D'Alembert's principle? Sum of external forces and sum of internal forces is equal to zero. Okay, so here external force is the F of t, internal forces are M2 B2x K x1 minus x2 minus Bx minus x1. So these are all the comes in the negative sign. So with that we are going to write the formula. So after that apply onto the particular mass formula as well as the spring formula and damper formula. So applying on that it will become the equation, it m2 into d square xy dt square plus b2 into dx by dt plus k into x minus x1 plus b into d dt of x minus x1 is equal to f of t is equal to first equation. So here the equation in terms of time domain, so we are going to convert this one into the frequency domain. So while converting the frequency domain, we are going to take the Laplace transform. While taking the Laplace transform of the equation, first it will become m2 s square x of s plus b2 s x of s plus k into x of s minus x1 of s plus b s into x of s minus x1 of s is equal to f of s. Okay, so then this equation, it will becomes like m2 square x of s plus b2 s x of s plus k into x of s minus x1 of s plus bs into x of s minus x1 of s is equal to f of s. Okay, so then here what is the output over here? X of s, input f of s, and one more displacement x1 of s. All the values are there, so here onwards we could not able to simplify over here, so that we have to find the x1 of s value. Okay, that we are going to find with the help of m1. So m1, what are all the forces it will be acting on the m1? Displacement is the x1, k1, k1the reaction forces, f1 is the reaction forces, this is the k spring force, that is the x1 minus x, while taking over here x1 minus x, f in terms of b, x1 minus x, b into x1 minus x, and there is no external force acting on this particular mass m1. Okay, so m1 is equal to rk1 rf1 rf into x minus x1 into rm1 rk into x1 minus x1. Okay, so here we are going to take in terms of b. So while substituting that the equation, it will becomes that mass and spring and damper formula, if you substitute it, that equation it will becomes like this. So in this equation, while taking the Laplace transform, it becomes m1 s square x1 of s plus k1 x1 of s plus b1 s x1 of s plus bs into x1 of s minus x of s plus k into x1 of s minus x of s is equal to 0. This is we are going to take in the fourth equation. So in the equation, we are going to take the common terms, that is the x1 of s is equal to m1 s square plus k1 plus b1 s plus bs plus k in minus x of s, if we are taking common, that is bs plus k is in the terms, it will come then equal to 0. So that here what we are going to do, we are going to find the x1 of s. So x1 of s is equal to x of s bs plus k divided by m1 s square plus b1 s plus bs plus k1 plus k. Okay, this is the fifth equation. Why? Because of we are going to find the output value. Output value is the x of s. So this our x of s, all the values it comes in the second equation in terms of x of s value. So that wherever the x1 of s is there, in the second equation you are going to put in terms of this equation. Okay, so if you are putting in this one, all the terms it will comes in terms of x of s terms. Okay, so then the equation it will becomes x of s into m2 s square plus b2 s plus bs plus k into m1 s square plus bs plus b1 s plus k1 plus k minus bs plus k whole square divided by m1 s square plus b1 s plus bs plus k1 plus k is equal to f of s. Okay, so now which is the input? F of s. Which is the output? X of s. So x of s divided by f of s, so that is the transfer function. It will become m1 s square plus b1 s plus bs plus k1 plus k divided by m2 s square plus b2 s plus bs plus k into m1 s square plus bs plus b1 s plus k1 plus k minus bs plus k square. So this is the transfer function of this particular physical systems. Okay, so like this way we are going to solve this translational problems. Okay, so the next video we are going to discuss about some other block diagrams. Thank you.